Welcome or welcome back. I should preface this piece with these comments. I once saw a short documentary on Joe Biden, and he seems like an all right guy. You know, he's a family man. He seems like an upright citizen. He served in the military. And his only major flaw seems to be that he's a politician. In any case, regarding hypocrisy, he was at a meeting recently in, I think it was in Kiev, regarding the whole Ukraine thing, and he made this statement, quote, "We believe that Russia has no right to do what they're doing," unquote. So I have a couple of questions for Joe. Exactly what is that that they're doing, Joe? Sticking their nose in a civil war? We don't ever do that, do we? Or maybe you're talking about annexing Crimea. We don't ever annex anything, do we, Joe? Have we ever annexed Hawaii, for example? Or Guam, or the Philippines, or... never mind the American Indian, Native American Indian lands in this country when we first got here. Never mind Gitmo, which we refused to give back, even though we took it at gunpoint. Come on, Joe. A little bit hypocritical, don't you think? Now, don't get me wrong, I'm no fan of Putin's. But he has some legitimate interest in that area. I mean, the Ukraine is right on the border of his country, and he has concerns about NATO moving eastward, which they've done since the fall of the Soviet Union, when an agreement was made stating that NATO would not move eastward. Anyway, that's that one. Okay, the next... example of hypocrisy is this business of austerity. You know, the IMF and other mega banks, etc., give countries these huge loans, and then when the loan is unsustainable, they want to impose austerity and or have the country sell their infrastructure, like their power companies, to private mega corporations. So the United States, they kind of look favorably on austerity for Greece and Italy and Spain and Portugal, etc. But not the USA. Oh no, no austerity here, at least not imposed by some bank. No, we're free. We don't get austerity, even though we have an $18 trillion debt, and we happen to be the largest debtor nation in the world. Prior to Ronald Reagan's terms, we were the largest creditor nation in the world. Now we're the largest debtor nation. But no, no, no austerity for us. No, no, guns and butter, guns and butter. Okay, the next one is, next item is spying. Spying on our allies in particular. You know, if we spy, we meaning the highest levels of the Fed government, in particular the NSA, if we spy on... our allies, oh, that's not a crime. But if one of our allies spies on us, oh my God, what a crime that is. Not too many years ago, we almost crucified an Israeli for spying on us. And then finally, Obama claims to be a constitutional scholar. But when you look at what he does regarding war, regarding aspects of the Patriot Act, such as FBI agents now get to write their own search warrants. No judge, don't need a judge's approval. They're called national security letters, not search warrants, but they serve as search warrants. And if you reveal the fact that they did search your house, you're subject to prosecution involving a sentence of 5 years in federal prison. So Obama claims to be a constitutional scholar, but if he is, he's sure ignoring the Constitution with all the things he's doing. Okay, I'm going to wrap it up. Thanks for dropping in. And let's hold our government to account for this hypocrisy. Let's have a national outcry once in a while. All right, take care. See you next time.